Good morning, everyone. If you would like to take your seats, a very warm welcome to our students, staff, families, and visitors to our Term 1 commencement service this morning. It is a wonderful, relatively recent tradition at PLC Armidale that we commence each school year gathered together as a school community to commence a year of learning and a celebration of the privilege that it is to be part of an all-girls school in regional New South Wales. And as is part of our commencement service, we will begin by a reflection from God's Word led by our chaplain, Miss Lay, following which I will then speak, and then we look forward to welcoming our Year 12 students into their new year, and then inducting our junior school leaders and some other leadership positions in peer support and co-curricular captaincy as well. So again, thank you for being here this morning, and I would now like to invite our chaplain, Jen Lay, to the stage. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. It is so nice to be back for another year. I hope you are ready for all that 2024 will hold. But this is a little snapshot for me of my break. If you have a quick look there, you can see what's going on. The top corner you can see is my baby niece, who is now a bit over two, and she is gorgeous. And I spent so much of my holidays looking after her and being with her. My veggie garden you can see is going off. It's quite amazing. My picture at the bottom is of olive oil. You might remember last year. It's a Dutch New Year's food that you eat every year. It's just one thing I look forward to every time. You might be going to say, what is that triangle thing at the top? Yeah? Oh, I heard a little whisper. Year 7, you should know. Miss Lay's getting chickens. I know, get excited, love that. Yes, I'm very excited about this too. Now you go, this is not secure. The plan was to get this finished by the end of the holidays. It obviously hasn't happened yet. Life is busy. But if you have a look in the middle, I have been doing a lot of reading over the holidays, which I love. It's something that I don't always get time to do, but I love, love, love having the time to do it. But you'll also see this is kind of the plan of what I wanted to do. Mr. Estridge, is this the same slide as yesterday, or is this the one I put as new? Thank you. Because you might be saying, oh, let's go back. This is the old one. No. Just give it a moment, let's work it out. But I hope you have feeling like you're ready for the term. Now, you would have seen on that book list, there is a book in there by a lady called Julia Baird, who is a writer who I love reading. Now, I don't always agree with every single thing she says, but I actually really love the way that she writes. I love the way that she tells people's stories, and I love the way that she looks beyond what is right in front of her to try and work out really what is going on. And amazingly, last night, as I was planning to go to bed, I realised that she'd just put another podcast out, so decided to listen to that after I watched, of course, You would know Survivor started last night, new series, ready. Titans vs. Rebels, come and find me at recess, we'll chat about it. It's going to be great. Mr. Estridge isn't there. Let's just roll on. Let's keep going. But as I said, there we go, perfect, thank you. This is the book that has stayed with me, but it is called Bright Shining, How Grace Changes Everything. Now, as you also know, I like to do a chapel chocolate of choice. Yes, I love the yeses, and you're 11, like you are, ready. My question for you is this, it's going to be first hand up, that's the way it goes, staff, you are out because you did this yesterday. What song is that line from, Bright Shining? Miss Montgomery. No, it's something you would have had more than once in here, but I love that was your choice of reference song. I guarantee you would have sung this. Oh, hang on, I've got Molly Chard with a massive wave from up the top. Molly Chard. Come and find me afterwards, because I've already refilled the chocolate jar, so get excited. So come and find me for this. Now, this is where she's taken this line from her song from her book from, is this song, Amazing Grace, where it says, bright shining as the sun. Now, her book is all about grace. Now, again, you might be sitting here going, Miss Lay, you're a bit late. Grit and Grace was last year. Or you might be going, hang on, why? Now, for me, while definitely Grit and Grace was Miss Taylor's theme last year, as a Christian, grace is something that I want to be amazed by, be inspired by, and be challenged by every single day. Class after class, conversation after conversation, person after person. I need to be inspired by this grace. Now, it is this most beautiful book. And again, it's worth a read just for the stories that she puts in. But she says this on page 5, which is what has stayed with me. Of course, religious circles are where people speak most often of the concept of grace, especially Christians who read in the Bible that their sins are forgiven by grace alone. This forgiveness, the wiping of the slate clean, is not deserved and can never be merited. When I read these words, these are a truth that as a Christian, and as the privilege it is to be the chaplain of PLC, these are words that I hold on to every day and do point me to the truth we find in the Bible. Paul puts it like this in Ephesians 2. But because of his great love for us, God, who is rich in mercy, made us alive with Christ, even when we were dead in transgressions. It is by grace you have been saved. And God raised us up with Christ and seated us with him in the heavenly realms in Christ Jesus, in order that in the coming ages he might show the incomparable riches of his grace, expressed in his kindness to us in Christ Jesus. For it is by grace you have been saved through faith. This is not from yourselves. It is a gift of God, not by works so that no one can boast. For we are God's handiwork, created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared in advance for us to do. I love this passage, and it's one that I think I have rolling around in my head quite a lot. Paul is really straight to the point. He goes, what is the reason? Why does God want to show grace? Well, it's actually all about him and nothing about us. Because of his immense love and his mercy, he wants to extend that to his people, the people he has made. This passage emphasizes that despite our shortcomings, our mistakes, and our mess-ups, God's love is continually there. He's steadfast and he's unwavering. His great mercy, which means he simply goes beyond what we can possibly imagine or deserve, he is there always willing to show that grace and mercy to each one of us. But did you notice where it says when he started doing that? It wasn't when we were lovable, it wasn't when we were ready. It's actually when he says that we were the people who were rejecting him, away from him, wanting nothing to do with his goodness. But even then, God showed how much he loved us. And he says that in the future, he's going to continue showing that to us. He's going to show his grace every single day. Not because of who we are, but because of who he is. This is a beautiful message about this salvation that it really is a gift from God. It's not something we can achieve on our own. It can only be accomplished by Jesus. And again, there's such a generosity in God's grace and his goodness. This passage reminds us that there's no good things that we can do to earn that. Instead, it's all about who God is. But instead, those good actions flow out because of knowing who God is and what he has done for us. It says we are considered God's masterpieces, the way that we are to live the day after day. It's a very beautiful and very simple passage that tells us exactly what it's about. As Molly worked out for us, well done again, Molly Chubb, come find me for your chocolate. This book, Bright Shining, takes that line from Amazing Grace. And you'll notice how beautifully that actually echoes this passage here. It reminds us at the very beginning, he says that saved a wretch like me. And right at the end, he talks about standing in this light and shining because of who Jesus is. As we begin our term and our school year, I have a prayer for us, and it's a prayer for myself as well, that we will be people who look to this grace that is so bright shining in our world that God offers, that we will look to the cross to see what salvation really cost, and we will seek those opportunities to show that grace and kindness to one another. Let me pray for that, and then we'll continue on. Heavenly Father, we do thank you so much that we are all returned ready for a new school year. Thank you for the opportunities and challenges ahead, and we pray that as we face each new thing, we'll be reminded of your grace and goodness. Thank you that we see this so clearly in your Son, Jesus, and it's in his name we pray all of these things. Amen. Can I invite you to stand, and we're going to sing our song, our beginning of term hymn, which is Lord, Behold Us. So please stand.
Take your seats, and as we gather here this morning, the staff, the students, and community of PLC Armidale, I wish to acknowledge that we commence this year of learning, of exploring, of serving, of journeying on land that for thousands of years has been cared for by the Anawan people, the traditional custodians. We give our respect to any Anawan people or Aboriginals past, present, and other Aboriginal Torres Strait Island people present with us this morning as well. Well, thank you, Miss Lay. It is, and welcome again to the 2024 academic year. It was fabulous to see so many people here at the welcome barbecue last night. I think that is about the fourth welcome barbecue that I've been to where it has rained after a period of dry, hot weather. So maybe we should just schedule that every year as the annual commencement rainfall as well. And thank you, girls, for reaching out to the girls that were new last night. I had a number of families who've joined PLC Armidale this year found me out to say they were so impressed that you looked out for new girls and made them feel welcome and not as awkward as sometimes it can be when you go somewhere for the first time. So it does give me great pleasure to welcome these girls. I think I've got the names on the screen there. Eliana, Ruby, Victoria, Natasha, Eva, Aurora, Harriet, Danielle, Abigail, Nika, Isla, Ruby, Brianna, Ella, Anna, Georgina, Ella, Addison, Hannah, Hansali, Eliza, Grace, Ella, Sophie, and Emily, Yuishan, Tina, Kathy, Fiona, Scarlett, Vicky, Wainey, Joey, and Danica, who are joining us in the Pathways program this year. Would you join with me in welcoming our new students to PLC Armidale? A And girls, if you're feeling, new girls, if you're feeling a little bit nervous about your first day and starting at PLC Armidale, you're in good company because there are some staff that are new to PLC Armidale and they're feeling a little bit nervous as well. So we do welcome Miss Alison Cox, who's joined us as the Enrolments Manager. Miss Ellie Cook, you will meet if you are a boarder, as one of our duty mistresses. Miss Emily Johnson will be working Monday to Wednesday as our college nurse, and she's looking forward to meeting many of you, especially the boarders. To Miss Asia Kleindeist, former PLC Armidale girl who has been the recipient of an education trainee opportunity that the Commonwealth Government have supported as an initiative for securing teachers in schools, and we were one of the first schools in the New England region chosen to host not one, but two education trainees, which I'm very thankful for. To Miss Bryony Looker, who is going to be working with us in the ag class, especially for stage five, as well as cattle team. Miss Brooke Maynard, who is our second education trainee. And then the two ladies at the end, Miss Campbell and Miss Stace, are not going to be cleaning the whole school. But we have chain caterers, and our new catering company, the Trippers White Group, are not going to be cleaning the boarding houses. So we have now employed our own cleaners. So boarders, be very kind to Miss Campbell and Miss Stason. They will be very good at cleaning your area in particular. We have some staff who've taken on new positions at the college as well, and I must send her sincere apologies. Mrs. Clint was in the car park this morning, so if you saw her car, you were not mistaken, but she is not actually well enough to be at school, but she wanted to be here as the mum of a new Year 7 student. And so we look forward to Mrs. Clint coming back, and this year she will be taking up the role of head of senior school, and Mr. Clendinning will be working in the humanities area, leading our humanities team. And Miss Flanagan has taken up the position as Director of Studies. We're looking forward to the work that Mr. and Mrs. Giacometti will continue doing this year, leading our boarding community. And Mrs. Faithful, Mr. Schumack, and Mrs. Weisel have taken on an extra responsibility in mentoring or supporting our two education trainees as part of that program I mentioned. Congratulations to Mr. Cotterill, who's going to be working very closely with Mrs. Donaldson to ensure that all things sport run smoothly and we are able to continue to increase and support the opportunities available to you girls in the sporting areas. And then we're also excited that Mrs. Prudy Woods will be working in our pre-K class each Friday in addition to the work that she has been doing last year in student support. You would have seen, I trust, the announcement about our 2023 HSC results once again demonstrating the PLC advantage. And I'm very delighted that we have retained our position as the school in the New England region, with particularly in Armidale, with the highest success score of any HSC cohort. Now, that's a bit of a funny measure and a funny word, but simply it simply says that we had a lot of girls that did very well in one or more courses that they chose to study. Over 58% of our HSC results were marks over 80 or 90, band 5 or band 6. And Chio Brown was both our dux and our valedictorian. Chio, along with 10% of the cohort, achieved an ATAR over 90. Now, there are many ways of measuring the successful outcomes. And for us, we're interested in where next for our Year 12 girls. Not just what did they get, but because we're investing girls in preparing you for life beyond school, where next? So I'm thrilled, having heard back from a lot of the girls, that they were offered the course of their choice. They were offered courses of choice in the universities of their choice. They have secured employment opportunities for this year, and they are very thankful and satisfied with the conclusion of their schooling, preparing them well for life ahead. Scholarships to residential colleges, offers of traineeships, and for many of them achieving personal bests in some of their subject areas, they're the marks of success and the character that they've grown along the way. But I would like to congratulate also Nevada Guyantz, who undertook HSE Physics in 2022 as an accelerant student, and Nevada attained a band 6 result in her physics study, And congratulations also to Scarlett Loxley, who undertook the study of software design and development, which is a very high-level computer coding program. And added to that complexity, Scarlett studied that subject via distance education mode, attaining a Band 6 result in her HSC for that as well. We had a record number of our creative and performing arts students achieve not only highly in their exam results, but actually be nominated for their work to be showcased at special performance evenings in Sydney. Now, whilst none of the girls were actually invited to go down to Sydney to perform, to still receive a nomination when you consider that there's about 75,000 people that did their HSC last year is still an outstanding result. So congratulations to Katie Alcorn, Gabby Cotterill, Harriet Gilpin, Phoebe Imberger, Nathia Pinkey, and Gabby and Phoebe were nominated in two different categories. So would you join with me? I know they're not here, but if we clap loudly enough, they might hear us. Would you join me in congratulating our class of 2023? Well, over the break, PLC Armidale girls were out and about hiking, rehearsing, performing, experimenting, researching, harvesting, working, serving, and having fun. So throughout the year, girls, we are very interested in knowing more about and acknowledging and celebrating your various interests and achievements. We know that the experiences that the girls undertake when they're representing the college, but we might not know if you've got a particular interest area that you're pursuing outside of school. We would still like to be able to celebrate that with you as a school community. So please let your class or your pastoral care teacher know, or let one of our prefects, especially the captains of sport or creative arts, know. Mrs. Arundale also will want to know because she loves being able to tell the great stories of PLC Armidale. Here are some of the accomplishments that I'm aware of over the break. Lily Meredith placed first in the 13 to 15 year old girls age champion at a recent equestrian jamboree in Armidale. Lillian attained a number of other impressive results at that meet as well, but that she was named as the age champion. We had 10 girls at the Gondwana National Choral School. So congratulations to Edie Clinch, Memantico Lay, Gia Ayler, Elise Tisserand, Bina DiVenuti, Jade Foster, Ali Bragg, India Smith, and Taya Catterall, who represented PLC Armidale. I also shared with the staff yesterday that one of Mr. Minter's compositions was selected for the girls at the choral school to learn as part of the big public performances that happen at the end of the 2 weeks. The choristers were not able to master Mr. Minter's composition, but if I say it's actually a composition that our junior school girls have performed at some of our public events, I think it shows how well our PLC Armidale girls sing and perform. And it was disappointing for Mr. Minter, but Mr. Minter will always sing your compositions here very loudly and proudly. Trista Dorian placed third in the under-14 singles and won the under-14s doubles event at the Gold Coast 125 tennis tournament, which was a very competitive field. And just as we were, or many of you were about to go on holidays, Steph Blake got on a plane and flew over to Perth to compete in the 2023 National All Schools Athletics Championships. And it was very exciting to be able to watch the live stream of that. I think Steph had in her sights a goal of running 400 metres in 1 minute. She ran 400 metres in 1.00.25. So really close. I think we can round it up to 1 minute. We had 4 girls that attended the National Youth Science Forum, and we're looking forward to hearing more about that from them as well. And congratulations, Ms. Looker has let me know that PLC Armidale has secured a place in the 2024 New South Wales School Merino Weather Challenge. So another area of endeavour for our girls to embark upon this year. I would like to congratulate one of our new Year 7 girls, Brianna Marshall, who was awarded the Young Citizen of the Year Award at the Gyra Australia Day Awards Dinner. So congratulations to Brianna, and hopefully you might like to share with your class what led to you being the recipient of that award as well. Well, not only have the girls been busy over the break, but much work has been done around the college campus as well. And you'll notice that our garden bed edgings are looking rather shabby at the moment. That is a work in progress to improve the finish of those. A special request for our boarders and girls that like to play near the volleyball net, could we try and refrain from getting too close to the hedge? Because it's got a few big dips in it from girls that like to use it as a bit of a trampoline at times. So we might not do that this year. That would be fabulous, thank you. But over their break, people have been working and serving at school to ensure that the campus is ready for our learning year to begin. I'm sure that over the break, many of you may have gone travelling on train, perhaps by train or plane or automobile, maybe even on bikes or on horseback. Well, our family, as a very special holiday to celebrate three very big birthdays, journeyed in a very different way. We went on this boat. It's called the Celebrity Edge Cruise Ship. And we cruised with my sister and some of her family, all 15 of us, to New Zealand for a wonderful 2 weeks exploring a country I'd not had the privilege of visiting before. On the first afternoon when I was on board, I was in the guest relations desk area and I noticed a portrait on the wall. And I thought, why would an American cruise line have that portrait on the wall? And this was the portrait in a beautiful big gilt frame. The story behind this is that there's a tradition for ships that when ships are launched, generally it's a member of the royal family, because it's a tradition that goes back centuries, a member of the royal family will come and smash a bottle containing very expensive wine against the bow of the ship to commission the ship as a sign of safety for all who travel within it. Well, when that ship was launched in 2018, the CEO of the company was a woman, and she didn't want to invite a member of royalty to come and commission the ship. She wanted to invite someone who had made a significant difference to the lives, particularly of girls and women. And so Malala Yousafzai was invited to come and launch that cruise ship. She didn't smash a bottle of French champagne against the bow of the ship. Instead, they had a very, very big bottle made filled with sparkling water. And again, that was symbolic of, whilst some people live in ease and plenty, others are still struggling for clean, fresh water supplies. Behind Malala's story, and that's what I wanted to share this morning, and I'm actually going to read the story that she has written that publicly she likes to have read reflecting her family. So these are in Malala's words. I was born in Magora, Pakistan on July 12, 1997. Welcoming a baby girl is not always a cause for celebration in Pakistan, but my father was very determined to give me the same opportunity a boy would have. My father was a teacher and ran a girls' school in our village. I loved school, but everything changed when the Taliban took control of our town in Swat Valley. The extremists banned many of the things that I enjoyed. We were not allowed to have a television, we were not allowed to play music or sing or dance, and they enforced harsh punishments for anyone who broke the rules. They also said that girls could no longer go to school. I could no longer go to school. My father no longer had a job. I spoke out publicly on behalf of girls and our right to learn, and this made me a target. On October 2012, on my way home from school, a masked gunman boarded the school bus and asked, "Who is Malala?" He then shot me on the left side of my head. After months of surgeries and rehabilitation, I joined my family. We had moved to a new home in the UK for my medical treatment, and I knew then I had a choice. I could live a quiet life, or I could explore, I could serve, I could journey to make the most of this new opportunity I had been given. And I was determined to continue my fight until every girl in Pakistan could go to school. I then began studying philosophy and politics and economics at the University of Oxford, and every day I fight to ensure that all girls receive 12 years of free, safe, quality education. I travel to many countries to meet girls who are fighting poverty, war, child marriage, and gender discrimination so that they too can go to school. I've set up a fund, the Malala Fund, where stories like mine can be heard around the world. Well, I graduated from Oxford University in 2020, the year the pandemic started. I will always treasure my time there. Although the global pandemic meant that I spent my final months as a university student studying in my parents' house, I am grateful I was able to complete my education. With more than 130 million girls out of school today, there is more work to be done. I hope you will join my fight for education and equality. Together, we can create a world where all girls can learn, all girls can explore, all girls can serve, all girls can journey, all girls can lead. Well, by now, you possibly have guessed my theme for 2024. Words that we shared last year to describe a particular experience for our Stage 5 students, but actually this year and in future years we want to expand our Explore, Serve, Journey program for all girls at PLC Armidale. It won't be the same. The peak experience for Stage 5 will always remain as a special experience just for Year 9, just for Year 10, but looking at ways that together we can explore, we can serve, and then we can journey. And that's my challenge to you this year as well. As you think about the year ahead, have you considered new aspects of learning that you would like to explore? New opportunities to be involved in groups that you would like to explore? New ways of connecting and building friendships that you would like to explore? Or ways of serving? The SRC are always keen to hear the girls' voices. The Fish Group, the various fundraising activities, all of our co-curricular programs are ways that you can serve each other and our school community. And then also to journey. What is it that you would like to grow in as a person this year? As a learner, as a friend, as a classmate? What is the journey ahead going to be for you? Some things for you to think about and goals for you to set for yourself this year. It is said that the journey of 1,000 miles or 1,000 kilometres begins with a single step. And so I am encouraging you to begin your journey to explore, serve and journey today. Would you join with me as I pray to commence our school year together, and then we will invite our Year 12 students to the stage. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for the privilege that it is to belong to a school community where we can, in safety and in peace, without fear of discrimination or recrimination, gather at the commencement of an academic year as a school community to worship you, but also to connect with each other and to commence the year ahead in our learning together. Thank you for our families and the trust they place in PLC Armidale. Thank you for the staff that have worked diligently over the break to prepare from the small detail to the big things the year ahead. Thank you for the girls that make it such a delight each day to be in this place and who bring so much joy into the classroom, into the playground, into the co-curricular activities. I pray that this year for each student and staff member of PLC Armidale, we will be willing to explore, to serve and to journey together. I pray this for Christ's sake. Amen. In Mrs. Clinch's absence, I'm going to invite Miss Flanagan to the stage. Miss Flanagan is going to read out the name of our Year 12 girls. And again, as is a relatively recent tradition, our Year 12 girls are presented with the badge denoting that they are in their final year at PLC Armidale, the first day of a whole series of last things for you this year, girls. But Miss Flanagan, would you like to come to the stage?
Good morning. It's my very great pleasure to introduce the class of 2024. So we'll start with Andrea Brown. Zoe Chen. Liberty Cook, Lily Dully, Lily Higgins, who's unable to be with us today, Caitlin Cable, Belle Lynn, Scarlett Loxley, Charlie Mack, Ellen Marsden, Hannah Mogada, Mia Montgomery, and VT Sinner, Sophia Venzella, Bella Waters, Georgia Wibley, Eileen Whitstead, who's also unable to be with us today, Alana Williams, Emily Wood, and Ellie Woods.
Considering that we are entering our 137th year as a school this year, we still like to look for new traditions that we can introduce. So one of our new traditions for this year is to induct our junior school leadership team at our commencement service rather than later in term one as we have done so in the past. So I'm now going to invite Mrs. Wake to the stage. Mrs. Wake is going to assist in the reading out of our junior school leadership names and positions and a little bit of an explanation about what responsibility these girls have in the junior school.
Thank you. Good morning, everyone, and I would like to restate Mrs. Taylor's welcome to our parents and to new students in the system as well. So without further ado, I'd like you to introduce you to our junior school leadership team, if you could just save your applause to the end. So our junior school head prefect, and her main role is to lead and manage the SRC in action group, to speak at formal occasions where the junior school is represented, to encourage and model our college values and rules, to always lead by example with humility and kindness, and to be encouraging of our Christian faith. The junior school head prefect for 2024 is Georgina Arendal-Fuller. The role of the junior deputy head prefect is to support the junior head prefect to carry out, just stated, herself committing to uphold the same values and responsibilities. The junior deputy head prefect for 2024 is Lucy Stephen. The role of the Junior Creative Arts Prefect is to assist the Head Prefect and Deputy Head Prefect with scheduling of creative arts items, to support and encourage others to be involved in creative arts, to meet regularly with the Junior School Prefecture at SRC meetings, providing opportunities for proposals to promote the arts, and to assist with the hanging and displays of student works, and to demonstrate enthusiasm and commitment to creative arts at PLC Armitage. The Junior Creative Arts Prefect for 2024 is Annabella Pisel. role of the junior sports prefect is to actively promote participation in sport across PLC Armidale, to act as a positive role model by demonstrating good sportswomanship in all activities, to participate in guild and intercollege competitions and foster guild spirit, to communicate information and reports in assemblies, and to attend sport prefect meetings. The junior sports prefect for 2024 is Evie Donaldson. Guild captains for each of our college guilds. The main role is to coordinate with senior school guild leaders, to coordinate guild gatherings and guild drama with other Year 6 students and senior school guild leaders, to encourage participation in sport and co-curricular opportunities, and be instrumental in building guild spirit. The 2024 guild captain for Dixon is Sophia Craig. Hamlin, Georgiana Ballard. Lovell, Predictor Shill, and Predictor is unable to be here with us this morning. But for Wilkie, we have Mary Notting. Shared leadership. Collective leadership opportunities are provided within the SRC and our guilds. This shared leadership model will provide the other Year 6 girls to lead with their guild captains as guild team leaders. It is my pleasure to introduce the 2024 guild team leaders for Dixon are Emily Christian and Farah Dinakara. Hamlin, Rose Hopkinson, and Isla Douglas. And for Lovell is Vicky Chu. Vicky may not be here with us. And for Wilkie is Pippa Notley and Mary Wanda. To induct the junior school leadership team with Beth.
So there's two parts to this. There's going to be a pledge that I'm going to ask the junior school leaders to make in front of us gathered, and then I'm going to invite the Year 12 student leaders to come to the front and find your respective or corresponding junior school leader and pin their badge onto their lapel and congratulate them for me. But excuse me turning my back to you, but I will speak directly to the girls. Girls, do you accept the position of peer leader? Do you promise to support the Christian principles of this school by being fair and kind, to care for others, forgiving when necessary, to do your loyal best, work hard, abide by the college rules, and represent the college well in the wider community, and to lead by example?
Join with me in congratulating our student leaders and Year 12 if you would like to come and pin their badges on.
whilst that was one visible demonstration of the support of the older girls for their junior school leader counterparts, the role of our peer support leaders is also important across the college, especially for enabling our Year 7 girls to quickly find their place and their people at PLC Armidale. And so I'm now going to ask Miss Lay, as chaplain and member of the executive team, to come to the stage to announce and read out the list of our peer support leaders. And then the words of our peer support pledge will be on the screen. And then I will ask the question I started to ask the junior school girls. Lots of different things in our service this morning. So Ms. Slay, if you would like to come to the stage, please, to announce our peer support leaders for 2024.
Thank you. I would like to start by actually just saying a huge thank you to the girls who did put their names forward to be a peer support leader. You certainly gave us a very hard job, but it gives me great pleasure to introduce our peer support leaders. Emily Blake. Ali Bragg. Taya Catterall. Daisy Donaldson. Anna Grills. Poppy McLaren. Bridie O'Neill. Grace Pageant. Holly Sheedy. And Emily Vanderwerf. Can you please congratulate Aggie 11 people later?
So the words on the pledge are. The words of the pledge are on the screen. I don't think girls are able to see that clearly enough to read out. So I will read the words for the peer support leaders and then do the pledge at the end. So as a leader, I will assist Year 7 students to become oriented within the college, help them with any problems that may arise, display the leadership by good example that would help build the students' self-esteem and ensure the continuation of our peer support program in future years. Be available to help my group during college hours with any emergency. Be their confidant whilst respecting their privacy. Maintain a comfortable environment which engenders trust and friendliness. Involve all group members on an equal basis. Arrive at group meetings on time and with adequate preparation to make the session worthwhile. And be supportive, understanding, patient and kind. Obey college rules and do my best to uphold the good name of PLC Armidale. And cooperate with my co-leaders and respect their opinion. So our 2024 peer support leaders, do you accept the position of peer support leader and will you abide by the commitments of this pledge? Thank you, girls. Would you join with me again in congratulating our peer support leaders? And in the interest of time, girls, we will have a photo now, but at the conclusion of assembly, I will invite you back to sign the pledge rather than doing that now because it's a very large group. Thanks, Ms. Kelly. So leadership and challenge is one of the four pillars of the PLC Armidale experience, and so leadership opportunities across a range of endeavours are sought and girls are encouraged to apply. We now are going to induct our leaders of our various co-curricular roles and responsibilities as well. Could I invite Mrs. Donaldson to the stage to assist in the reading and presentation of our sport captains, please?
Well, good morning, girls and parents and staff. It gives me great pleasure to announce this morning and for the girls to come up and to receive their badges, the 2024 sports captains. Our equestrian captain, Sophia Vanzella. Our soccer captain, Georgia Whibley. Our hockey captain, Captain Ellen Marsden, and Deputy Captain, Ellie Woods. Netball captains, our captain, Lily Higgins, who's not able to be with us this morning, and our deputy captain, Bridie O'Neill. Our rugby captain, Mia Montgomery. Our swimming captain, Poppy McLaren. Our tennis captain, Daisy Sheedy. Touch football captains, Matilda George and Sophie Young. And our cattle team captains, our captain, Lily McCosker, and our deputy captain, Libby Cook. Last round of applause for our 2024 sports captains.
Our creative and performing arts captains, and I'm going to invite Mrs. Wisehall to come and assist in the presentation of these awards, of these badges.
Well, good morning, everyone. I'm delighted to announce the 2024 Kappa captains. For drama, joint captains Taya Catterall and Emily Blake. Our music captain for 2024 is India Smith. Our dance captain, Andrea Brown. And our art captain, Ali Bragg. Big round of applause for our creative arts captains for 2024. I might also just invite Mr. Minter up for our photograph as well.
Just before we sing our concluding song, the school song, I'm going to invite Mr. Minter and Mrs. Weisel and I think Mrs. Donaldson again to the stage. They're each going to explain some of the processes for girls that are very keen to be signed up for a number of the sport and co-curricular activities. Girls, we felt, I know it's a little bit longer in the assembly, but we felt it was important to do that today because with the rollover of IT, then you won't be able to do that online today or tomorrow. So thank you, Mrs. Donaldson.
Thank you, Mrs. Taylor. Girls, I just wanted to communicate to you how your I know existing students will know or may have forgotten, but definitely to our new students, how you're going to be able to sign up for your extracurricular activities. And with the IT being rolled out over the next two or 3 days, some of you will not have access to it until later in the week. So in period three today, I will be coming around, myself and Mr. Cotter will be coming around to your pastoral care periods, lessons, and you'll manually sign up for your sports. So you'll be able to ask me any questions when I come in or Mr. Cotrell comes in if you're not sure. They do, if you were here last year, they're similar as term four. I'll spend a little bit more time with year seven. I can answer and explain to you how and when the different sports are. Year 12, because you're so grown up, you will be able to just come and sign up for them on the sports notice board once I've done all of the year groups. So period three today. So between now and then, which is that isn't actually that long, if you have a think about what sports you might like to play, remember it's not compulsory to do sport at PLC, but it's highly encouraged, and it's a lot of fun and a great way to create new friendships and just try something new. So period three today, we'll be signing up for sports, and the swimming carnival is our first whole school event, which is coming up in week three, Thursday of week three, not too far away. You will sign up for these events within a guild gathering in week two. So your guild captains will come and twist your arms to go in every event possible and to get those guild points, but you'll sign up within your guilds in week three and for the in week two, and for the junior school you will sign up with them with your class teacher, so that if you've got any questions about how long the 25 meter is or the 100 meters, especially if it's the first time for you to be swimming in that very large long 50 meter pool, so we'll do them with you with your class teacher, the junior school, but senior school you'll do them with your guild leaders, and they'll be able to answer any questions about that. So they're our first events, for our first big event, but have a think about what you might like to go in, and remember it's all about getting points. It's not about being, well, it is about being the fastest for some, but it's about just getting in and showing that great great spirit and starting the year off really well, and go Hamlin.
Welcome to the 2023 choir pieces. I'll just enjoy this for about 1 minute, 20 seconds. Okay, so ladies, last year I came into the room and I was not sure what to expect, but it was before the carols. I thought, oh, well, we better do a whole school carols practice. And then I heard the voice of PLC. It was unbelievable. particularly the people on this side of the room, do you remember? Anyway, it was incredible, and I thought, good grief, talk about explore, serve, and journey. That's what we're doing this year. So you've heard the magnificent songs. We are going to sound like that even better. Come along to choir Monday morning, 7:45, and it's going to be fantastic. And then after choir comes all of those other millions of ensembles. So for junior school girls, come along on Friday morning to Treble Makers, 8 o'clock. Okay, 8 o'clock in the music room, junior school. Anyone who wants to come do a bit more singing, come on down at 8 o'clock on Friday. Now, we've got today, we're having a new system for signing up. Do you want me to talk about that, Mrs. Weiser? So we've got a new system when we work together in this fabulous new Kappa faculty. And so there's going to be an announcement on Edumate, and then there's going to be the intranet. So if you haven't sort of got familiar with that yet, the fabulous intranet via the Connect tab. You can go in there, and for all of your things that you want to sign up to do, you go in there and do it in that spot. So that's ensembles, hiring of musical instruments, and also any peripatetic lessons that you might want to roll up and learn. So the thing is, if you were in a group last year, you're automatically in that group for next year. So you only have to do that process if you are a new student for an ensemble. But we would like everyone who has an instrument on hire this year, all instruments that are on hire, and preferably all, even if you were doing lessons last year, to please fill out the form when it comes through for instrumental co-curricular lessons and also for instrument hire. That would be fantastic.
Great, thank you, Mr. Minter. So just to reiterate, there is going to be one form for all of the Kappa ensembles. So if you want to do chamber ensemble, and you also want to do dance ensemble or drama club, it is the same form. You just nominate which ensemble. It's a Google form, so we're moving from our paper sign-ups, so it's going to be the same form that we will send out to you this week sometime. There's no real kind of pressure, so because we'll be starting in the next couple of weeks with our ensembles. So with our dance and drama and visual arts, it's pretty similar to last year, in that our dance ensemble is still on a Tuesday lunchtime for our senior school girls. Our junior school girls, your dance ensemble is still on a Monday afternoon. And we still have the lovely Miss Asia. But this year, you need to call her Miss Kleindienst, because she's actually one of our teacher education trainees. So she's Miss Kleindienst this year. So that's our dance ensemble. There will be another opportunity for another couple of ensembles, but I will let you know about those. Drama club and theatre sports will still be on a Wednesday lunchtime. The most important thing for this week, though, and this is for junior school and senior school, I'm delighted to be able to tell you that speech and drama will start up again. We had a little hiatus for a couple of years for our senior school girls. We have the beautiful and most amazing and very qualified speech and drama teacher, Mrs. Carly Alcorn, who is going to be taking over a lot of Mrs. Patterson's students. Mrs. Patterson is still well, and she will be helping our CVCA students, for those in year 11, but Mrs. Alcorn will be running speech and drama for year 4 girls all the way up to year 11. So if you are in year 4 or year 5 or year 6 or 7 or 8 or 9 or 10 or 11 and you would like to do speech and drama AMEB exams this year, can you please come to the drama room this Friday at lunchtime? So this Friday at lunchtime, Mrs. Alcorn will be in the drama room. So junior school girls, you are going to be led by your creative arts prefect, Annabella, and senior school, Ashley. We might get Bella as well. The two Bellas, isn't it great? Both creative arts prefects are called Bella this year. So Bella in senior school and Bella in junior school are going to walk our junior school girls over from the foyer in the junior school to the drama room at Friday lunchtime. So junior school girls, if you would like to do speech and drama from year 4 or 5 or 6, you can meet both Bellas in the foyer and they will take you to the drama room. Senior school girls, you know where to go. Come to the drama room at lunchtime on Friday to sign up. There'll be lots and lots more information coming each Monday, but those are the kind of two big things, choir and speech and drama so far.
And just one key thing, if you senior choir, there's no need to audition. Anyone can go. The other choirs, they will be auditioned. For year 7, Mrs. Dunham will be coming around tomorrow to get your names of anyone who wants to be in any ensembles. The form, if you're interested in being an ensemble, write down your name, or there's basically a ticker box thing, Even if you're not sure whether or not your standard, if you play an instrument, you want to be in the jazz band, just write down jazz band. If you want to be in the strings, we're going to have two string ensembles in the senior school this year. So we've got two different string teachers, Robert Van Gent and Joanna Fairswoot. So just write down if you want to be in that string group, and then we'll work out those details. Those ensembles start next week, except for piano trio. That's one exception because there's a few Friday things. All ensembles start next week, so there's no troublemakers on Friday girls in the junior school. And that's, yeah.
Thank you.
Did you have that up in that?
Yes. So just on the speech and drama thing too, if you're not sure what it is and you're feeling, oh, I'm a bit shy, I can't do speech and drama is for people who are really confident and get up and talk. Actually, if you are shy, speech and drama is just for you because it helps you and trains you in building confidence. So if you're a little bit worried, come and have a try. Just come on Friday lunchtime and we'll show you what it all means and what it looks like. It's lots of fun. You don't have an individual lesson, you're in a group. Okay, so that's Kappa. One last announcement, just for the whole senior school. Junior school, you're sorted, but for senior school, before we sing our song, is that lunches today, because we still have a few issues with our IT system and we're just rolling people onto their laptops, you're not able to order your lunch online today. So if you would like to order lunch, you are going to do that in your PC, in your partial care session next, manually with your partial care teacher. The options are spicy burrito with red lentils or salad bar. So if you need to order your lunch today, please make sure you write your name down with your pastoral care teacher, and then Mr. J will come around during pastoral care and collect those from the pastoral care teachers. Okay, thank you, girls.
Girls, a slight change to our schedule in the senior school. We're actually going to go straight to recess now and have a break now and then go into pastoral care in period four. So it will be recess when the bell rings straight back into your pastoral care room, please. Would you thank you again, family and visitors, for attending. It's been a bit of a longer morning than we were anticipating, but I do appreciate you being here. Would PLC Armidale collectively like to stand as we sing our school song together? Thank you.